beats.
So what it do, YouTube? Mr. EAZYE does it, back at it with another video for today. Man, I know it's been a while since I last uploaded a video, bro. But I explained everything in the last video, so if you didn't watch it, man, you best go watch it, bro, because I explained everything. So, yeah. But anyways, guys, I just want to make this little quick video because I do keep getting a lot of people on Instagram and on YouTube here in the comments asking what I have on my truck and stuff like that. So, and I've been over that like a million times, but I guess they're new and they don't know or whatever. But I'm just going to go over everything about my truck in this video, so listen up because I'm so tired of getting these questions every single day, literally every single day. So let's just start off with the interior real quick. Starting out with the most asked question about my interior, on what stereo do I have? This one is a dual single dent touchscreen. Obviously I don't want to touch it, or actually not, screw it. Yeah, see, it's a little touchscreen or whatever from the brand Dual. This thing does come off, see. Sometimes it gets stuck, but you can put like a little SD card in there and stuff like that. USB, a little aux cord and stuff like that. I've been having this since like, what, 2018? I don't know if you can tell, but right here. I don't know how, bro, but it chipped off right here. And it's starting to kind of chip right here. Very chipped off right here. I guess it's from the heat. I'm not so sure, but hey, this was actually pretty good. It was like, damn, I think at the time it was like 120 or something like that. Pretty cheap, but it looks badass. It was way better than the stereo I had. But yeah, it's a dual single dent touchscreen 7-inch screen or whatever. Just look it up. I think they sell it at Walmart too. I've seen it there, but yeah. And then for the LEDs right here, because sometimes I'll be posting myself driving at night, people asking me what I have on this right here. It's just a T10 blue LEDs. You just replace the little stock bulbs or whatever, and we'll give it like a whole blue effect or whatever. And the same with the little AC bulbs right here, the little AC control. I think they were like T3 bulbs. They're really small, but they're annoying as hell. This one sometimes goes out and stuff like that. But yeah, all this lights up at night, all blue and stuff. This little button is for my fog lights, which I'll get to it later. And for speakers, well, obviously you guys already know it just has these little speakers right here in the corner, and the ones over here in the dash. But they're just, I think they were, I can't remember, they were Pioneers, the ones that I got. Either Pioneer, I think they were Pioneers. I'm not really sure. I can't remember, honestly. But I don't have no fancy speakers here. I don't have no subwoofers, whatever the hell y'all want to call them. I call them that because it's funny as hell, woof woof. But I don't have none of that bass stuff. I just have these little, well, they're not really stock, but, you know, the little small ones that the truck comes with. But yeah, other than that, like, oh yeah, and then the bucket seat right here that I got at the junkyard off of a Suburban. And but yeah, that's pretty much it. For the interior, I'm gonna keep it stock for now. Like, I love this classic look. Maybe later on we'll do something different, but for now I'm gonna keep it stock. But yeah, that's pretty much it about my whole freaking interior. Yeah, and before I actually get the questions answered, I'm gonna just get this out the way real quick. I'm not trying to be salty or anything like that, but I am not gonna be giving out my paint code for the paint on the truck. And like I said, I'm not trying to be salty. I just don't want my truck to, because you guys already know my truck is unique as hell with the paint color or whatever the hell you want to call it. It's unique as hell. There's not a lot of trucks out there like that. Like, there's here and there, but I'll just give y'all a hint. It is an OEM color, original color, from back in the 90s. So y'all want to go look it up, be my guest. But getting back to the video, the drop that I have on this truck, it is a 2.4 drop. You know, people always out here clowning on people saying, oh, you got a little baby drop. Boy, get your motherfucking facts straight. It's a 90s style. You already know we don't go that low on these trucks. But I do have 2.4. I do have shackles back here, shackles and hangers. Y'all can see right there, 2-inch shackles right there, no stock stuff. And then the hangers are all the way over here. Let me see if I can get a better view, but yeah, I got the hangers right there. So yeah, on both sides, obviously 4-inch. Yeah, in the front, obviously I do have a two-inch drop. Man, I'm getting confused as hell, bro. Just a little springs, but I'm kind of thinking of just getting rid of the shackles and the hangers for later on. Maybe just adding a flip kit to make it go 5 inches. You know, it can sit really nice. But we got to see with the wheels whenever I get them with the baby billets and stuff like that. We just got to see how it sits. But I honestly feel like a 2.4 drop is a perfect drop, perfect stance for a 90s style. But yeah, the skirts on the truck. Okay, so people ask me, where did I get the skirts? The skirts came with the truck when my dad got the truck back in, I think, 02 or 03. It came with the truck. It is a Cheyenne model. It's just the normal Cheyenne. But I guess it's just, like, aftermarket skirts. So, yeah, it's not, like, a Mark III or, like, a super show truck like that. It's just a normal Cheyenne with aftermarket skirts. That's it, bro. Y'all don't need to make it so complicated. But the skirts, they don't make them anymore. The only way you can find them is if somebody's selling them on Instagram, Facebook Marketplace, somewhere around there. Or maybe, if you get lucky, at the junkyard, they'll have them. But, you know, most of the time, they're all cracked, destroyed. Like, I mean, y'all can fix them up if they're not, like, broken in half and stuff like that. But, yeah, I've noticed that the skirts are making a huge comeback.
I remember back then, people were telling me, oh, just take out the skirts. It looks ugly as hell. Like, bro, I know what the hell I've been doing. Like, I love me the 90s style. Like, that's just my personal preference or whatever. Because, you know, I'm a paisa. My dad was a paisa. And, you know, we grew up like that. So, yeah, that's just me.
Back here in the tailgate. Well, in the back, in the booty, whatever. Let's start off with the tips right here. So these are your typical paisa tips, that just sticking out. The exhaust that I have on this truck, I believe it was a Super 10. I can't really remember, but it's a classic for all the OBS trucks, you know, with the little 4.3 and 5.7s. It sounds mean as hell. I'll see if I can do like a startup video, or I don't know yet, but yeah. And then the tail lights right here, they are LEDs that I got off eBay. So I've had them since 2018. I had a problem with this one recently. I guess one of the cables got loose and it wasn't turning on, but it works now. I don't know, it's weird, but since 2018, 2021, I already know. This is nice as hell. And then I do have the Lossfit LED reverse light, so. And then this little sticker I got off eBay, like, damn, I think it was back in 2019. I don't know, I mean, it looks nice, so. I didn't want the truck looking all basic as hell, so yeah. And yes, I do have a bunch of orange peel in the truck because I never got it wet sanded or buffed out. I still need to go do that crap, but yeah. I mean, my paint job isn't the best. It's kind of crappy, but it's way better than before. I really don't care because later on, I'm going to repaint it, so yeah. And for the tint, I do have limo tint. I don't think I can tell, but it is 5%. This one back here. Man, I don't even know. Can you see on the inside? Because I can clearly see on the inside, but it is 5%. And then right here, y'all can see the little eyebrow. It is 5% too. It is extended as well. I don't have no windshield tint, so windshield tint looks ugly on OBS trucks, especially in 90s, but that's just my personal preference. And this truck is an original Cheyenne. This is an aftermarket badge, but it's all faded now. It's not a Silverado, because y'all could tell. I'll prove it to y'all. It is an original Cheyenne too, because I don't have power windows. See, he even says it right down the little OG badge, Cheyenne. And my wheels, these are old school AR39s, American Racing. You know me, my little takuache shit. I had these on the IROX, little spike lugs. It looks nice as hell. I do have the caps, but they're all broken as hell. But these are 15s, and then my tire size. Where's it at? Right here. It's all backwards, but y'all can pause the video because I'm not trying to. Well, actually, I'll just put it in the screen or whatever so y'all can see the tire size right there. But actually, it's a 235/75. What the hell, bro? I'll just put it in the screen. And now for the most requested asked questions that annoy the hell out of me. So, okay, let's get this straight, guys. These headlights, yes, they do have the little LED bar. Let me show y'all real quick. I don't know if y'all can tell, but they do light up. These, my girlfriend got them from me, but she got them off eBay. And like I said before on my Instagram story, these lights go out of stock like ASAP. And I know if you go on eBay right now, they're not gonna be right there like on the search results and stuff like that, which sucks. That means they're out of stock. But like I told y'all before, they stock them like at the most random time. So if you look them up, they'll come up out of nowhere randomly. But yeah, she got them off eBay there at the time, like what, almost 2 months ago. I think they do sell them on other websites, but like really expensive, like 200. At the time, she got them for like 125. I think we're like at a discount or something like that. But yeah, it was just the top headlights. I don't have the bottom ones yet, but that'll be later on. Hopefully, but I don't really care right now. For my bulbs, obviously, I converted everything to LEDs, the Lossfit LED, the Oxido low beam right here, high beam.
And these little ones, the clear corner lenses, I got off of eBay as well. Lost fit switchbacks. And this is right here, the valence. I did get this valence off of homeboy. It is a 454 one, clone, whatever. But I think they do sell that on Amazon, or I know for sure they sell it on LMC trucks, but it's expensive as hell. And then the fog lights I got off Amazon. So yes, these fog lights are on Amazon. I am on my second pair already. Cause this one, the wire got messed up. I don't know if y'all can really tell, but look at the way it's hanging. And I'm stupid as hell, bro, cause I didn't even check the little hill and my valence almost cracked and it did bend the little frame of my fog lights, so it's all messed up now, but it is what it is, bro. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video and hopefully I answered some of y'all's questions that y'all been asking. Don't get all booty hurt about my paint code because I'm not giving that out. Like I said, here's a hint, it is an OEM color, so go look it up. But anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Y'all make sure to give it a thumbs up, comment, because it helps with the YouTube algorithm to get my videos pushed out there. And if you're new to this channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button. You already know it. Make sure to go follow me on Instagram. It easy does it. Put it here below. Man, y'all better go follow me, bro, because all my stories on there are funny as hell. Y'all already know it's all rated R or whatever. Como se dice? Edge rated R superstar. Anyways, guys, yeah, it's funny as hell. If y'all want to follow me, I keep y'all updated on there and all that stuff, because, you know, I'll be on there most of the time. I'm active on there all the time, but yeah. But yes, all right, well, you should have known by now, Mr. EAZYE does, and I'll just catch you on the next one. Peace.